that we know. So we came and we went to the youth room and we made Easter cards. And we drew them ourselves and we decorated them and wrote a cute little message. And we took them to the Pleasant Springs nursing home. There we got to visit with everybody and pass out cards and hear some stories. And that was really neat. After that, we finished that we were done with our projects for the day. So we went home to the youth room and we just kind of did various discussions and Bible studies throughout the day. We had some video clips that we could watch in the youth room, kind of getting us in touch with the kind of kids we can help all over the world. And if you want to know more about what we learned during those discussions, come find one of our tie-dye shirts and talk to us. After all that, we put together our services parts. We got together the songs, we practiced things, and the three of us wrote this little sheet that we're doing. And afterwards, we built our city. We had these huge cardboard boxes, and we were out in the park yard, and we arranged them, we made our little houses, made them cozy, and laid out sleeping bags, got nice and warm-ish. And then we slept out there for a while. Now, I left a little bit early because it was getting a little cold for me. But eventually the rain started coming in and everyone had to come in. We slept comfortably in the youth room. This morning we've been practicing, we've been cleaning, we hid Easter eggs for the little kids, and now we're right here. Afterwards, as Betty Merriweather has provided us with some delicious lunch. Thank you so much. And that's what we've done this weekend. So now I'm going to go into my short, I promise, thing. Starting with my verse, which is Isaiah 58:10. If you offer your food to the hungry and satisfy the meals of the afflicted, then your light shall rise in the darkness and your gloom be like the noonday. When I read this verse, I thought, okay, it's about selflessness. Cool. Well, we've been pretty selfless this weekend. That's kind of the point. And I feel like I've now, after not eating for 30 hours, I kind of trying to understand it a little more. It's really hard in our world where we have access to anything, whatever we want it. But watching these videos and then kind of feeling sort of almost what they have to feel this weekend with all the exhaustion and headaches and tired and everything, it's kind of put me at a place where I can almost understand what's going on. And it's kind of made me personally feel a lot more sympathy and a lot more, I feel like I would help for someone more now than I would before because I know how they're feeling. So I wrote this last night and I wasn't thinking straight, so let me try to figure out what I was thinking.
Join with me in the youth group. us once again go before God in prayer. Let us pray. Almighty Father, we come before you on this day, and we ask that you would continue to give us strength as we look to do your service out in the world, to find new ways to reach out to those in need and help those who are suffering. Lord, on Palm Sunday, we cry out Hosanna, because you are the one who saves us, and you were able to save yourself from the ultimate death. You died and rose again and forgave us of our sins, and we are forever grateful. God, as we come before you on this joyful day, Lord, we ask that you hear the prayers of concern and joy that we have. Today we lift up a concern for Tommy Wayne. We pray for Bill's sister, Jackie. We pray for Joe Butler and her coming surgery. Lord, we pray for Jeannie Pruitt's mother, Glenna. Lord, we pray for Rachel Breland. Lord, we pray for those who are not with us because they're not able to come to church today. For our brothers and sisters like Charlene Stepp, God, we ask that you continue to be with them as they heal. And God, we lift up those people who we have not named, who are heavy on our hearts, family and friends and people we know in this community that are suffering, Lord. We ask that your healing hand would be upon them and that you would give them strength through your Holy Spirit. Loving Father, we also come before you today with great joys. Lord, we come before you giving you thanks for those who have had birthdays well beyond their 100th year. And we lift up the lives of those people who have been able to come so far. We pray for Rebecca, and we give thanks that she was able to get a new job, as well as Clint, as he also found a new job and is in a better situation. And Lord, we give you thanks for the youth, for their dedication to this church, for the service of Jesus Christ that they are committed to, and for the joy that they bring to each and every one of us. We give you thanks and praise. Lord, we also give you thanks for people like Jonah who have come out of the hospital and are recovering. And we love to hear good news of those people who are suffering and struggling with diseases. And Lord, we give you thanks for this congregation and the love and the witness that they are for this community of Mount Pleasant and beyond. God, we ask today that you would lift us up, take us under your wing, and continue to move us to be your disciples, ever concerned with those who are in need. And Lord, now we ask that you hear our prayer as we pray as you have taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Now we will stand and sing together hymn number 297. Hosanna.
Thank you.
Taylor Medicine. Friends, you have heard the testimony and all that these youth are dedicated to you. These young people are committed to the service of Jesus Christ, and they have done an incredible thing, and now they are ready to go and eat. Yes, and you continue to pray for them as they recover from this fast. And now we have a special blessing that we will sing to you.
Go now in peace, may the love of God surround you everywhere you may go. Go now in peace, may the love of God surround you everywhere you
Question.